Hi, it's Bob Kraft of tennisministry.org. I'm going to bring up an interesting topic, Wimbledon and terrorism. Now, I was there during the championship when they had the bombing on the subways and the bus. I was actually getting ready to leave the championships a day or two later, as I remember, and I would have gone right through that area where they had the bomb and the subway tube bombings. And as I came into the championships, I actually took the tube and went through that station. That would have been the way I'd gone back. And so it was very much impactful to the people. The championships changed overnight from that. What happened was immediately they started to put into place ways to keep terrorists from attacking the All England club. And it was an amazing thing to see. I remember I had my bag, my backpack, on a table outside, kind of where people have a snack, the players and some of their guests. And I walked over to this coffee bar, which was about 10 yards away. And I happened to be sitting at the table with two ladies who I didn't know, and also the umpire of the All England Club Championships. And he started screaming at me. He said, "Whose bag is this?" And he knew it was my bag. And I walked back, and he goes, "If that bag is left here, I'm going to have the police come and take it away and blow it up." You know, I was shocked. But it was really about fear, the fear of what was happening. And having been an intelligence officer myself back in the 1970s in the U.S. government, I'm very always aware of things that are happening with terrorism, actually. It's how I was trained. I went through many courses of counterintelligence, so I'm always paying attention to security cameras, how the security is set up, and also the vulnerabilities of how people can get in and create problems. So I'm aware of that. In fact, I've shared that with the U.S. Open. I knew there were ways to get in, and I shared that with the head of security, which wasn't much appreciated, I must say. But then I've also noticed that at Wimbledon, as of a few years ago, there were vulnerabilities, and I never shared that with anybody. But, you know, it's something we need to pray about, because there are people whose purpose is to hurt others. And as Christians, we need to not be like that. We need to pray. In fact, every day I went to the tournament, I prayed for the head of security, I prayed for the security guards, and I prayed for the safety of that tournament, along with the players. And we just need to continue to lift them up. Right now, they don't let fans queue outside on the near the wall of the Wimbledon Championships, whereas they used to be able to do that. Now they stretch them for hundreds and hundreds of yards away from the wall. They don't let cars near the where the entrances are. They have barriers put up there. They have police everywhere, and they have backpack searches when the fans come in, including the players. The players can't get into the players' lounge without backpack searches. And I would just also like to share that, you know, people who have that mentality are just not people that we hear about on TV. It's really a mentality of destroying people, hurting others, drawing attention to themselves. And that could go with players too. There was one particular player who came from a Muslim country who I felt was radical, and her family, and I won't mention that name, I just will tell you it was a sense that I had. I talked to them and I saw them, and you know, it wasn't something just about the fans. We need to be aware of this, not just with the people outside of the gates. It's a very sad thought process. We need to pray for the players and the tournaments around the world. And you know, from my standpoint, this is not just about a Christian viewpoint. I'm a pastor. I'm a church member. But on the other hand, I'm also trained in the intelligence field, and it's something that I'm well aware of. I was very much involved in that with the Iranian hostage situation back in 1979, and you know, I'm aware of what happens and how it impacts people, and I'm taking that to the tennis tournament too, and that's why I'm mentioning it to you for prayer. Thanks.